Hello, welcome to the Wealthy Trades Daily and Weekly Market Forecast for April 27th, in the week of April 27th, 2015. Let's get started right away. Last week we had a decent week. We actually ended up, the weekly trades looked really, really good. Our earnings trades looked really good. I'm not going to go through the entire week, but some of the highlights of last week was our pairs trade, long KR and short SWN. Was up about 1.73%. That was good. And then our earnings trades did very, very well. I sent an email out on that yesterday. So anyway, let's just dive right in on what we're going to be doing. So that's just the real quick recap of last week. Day trades got a little choppy. Obviously, we were doing pairs trades throughout the whole week, kind of moving up and down. And it looks like we're going to be doing a pairs trade again this week. So let's move right into this week's price action. Okay, so I actually want to talk about the weeklies first and foremost. Last week we did a pairs trade, which ended up being good. We were long KR and short SWN, and this week it looks like we are going to be doing just a pure long trade, long trade in the XLU, and that's it. And the reason why is because we are in an uptrend. Okay, 73.3% of the stocks are moving up, and the quality of that uptrend on a weekly basis is above 50%. The XLU is the best sector within the stock market. Okay, so what I'm going to move all the stocks within the XLU into my portfolio on a weekly basis. So I'm clicked on the weekly tab, okay, and then I click the plus symbol on the XLU, and then I'm going to scroll down. And I'm going to add all these stocks, okay? These are the top eight stocks. I'm going to add them to my portfolio also. And we're going to go through these, and we're going to find the best opportunity. Now, here's a little caveat. The XLU doesn't have all it has good opportunity. It is the best sector. But the stats on the levels to win stats that you'll see are not that great. What we typically want to see is we want to see a levels to win profit on both sides. Well, we're going to come to find out that within the XLU itself, as you can see, not a winning on both sides. None of these actually win on both sides. And, you know, that's not great. You know, obviously one of the things we want to see is it win on both sides. But with the XLU, we don't typically get that. And one of the reasons why is because the XLU is more of a safe haven. It has less of a range, meaning it doesn't move as much. The utility stocks don't typically move as much as, you know, healthcare stocks or technology stocks. It has less beta, or to put it another way, it has less volatility. So the one way that we're going to pare this down to the best opportunity is we could just simply look at the ones that have the highest hit rate on the trend side, ED and CMS. But we're going to take it a little further, okay? So, and ED and CMS are probably going to be ones that we're going to look at, but I'm just going to simply look at the spread between the levels on levels. So how often, what is the probability, SCG, for example, closed at 74 or 72? Well, what is the probability of it closing, and it should hit 55.92? What is the probability of it closing above that 55.92? Well, I know that based on the levels on levels, and it's got a 26.9% probability. All right, so the expected downside in this uptrend is 53.52. And we can look at this on the chart, too, down here. We can kind of see, okay, well, how does this look, the expected upside? And technically, you know, I think a lot of these are going to look similar. They look like they're coming off of lows and actually looking to, you know, probably poised to rally a little bit. So that's good. But we can see that the expected low is 53.52, and it has a 23.1% probability of closing below that. So that's not that great compared to the ones that we typically look at. But let's compare that to ETR. ETR is obviously better because it's got 30 and 21. So I'm going to eliminate SCG because ETR is better. Let's look at EIX. It's got 30.8 and 23.1 compared to 30 and 21. So ETR is better than EQX. Okay, so I'm going to eliminate that one. So we're kind of using a customized, and look at ED. It does hit this on a very high rate, yes, but ETR hits it at a pretty high rate too. But ETR has a tendency of closing above more often than ED. So I'm going to eliminate ED, saying ETR is slightly better. Now let's go to Duke, 34 and 23. That's good. That's over 11. So, you know, Duke is actually slightly better than ETR, okay, because it's got a higher spread. All right, let's look at DTE. Duke is better than DTE. CMS, 32 and 27. I'm going to bust out the old calculator here, and we're going to go 34.6, 23.1. We've got 11.5% spread there. Probably do that in my head, but it's too early to do that kind of stuff in my head right now. So 11.5. Okay, so CMS and Duke basically have the same spread between the levels on levels. Now, one of the ways that we can eliminate this is we can say, well, which one hits the trend side more often? That's CMS. And then which one hits the counter trend less often? And that's also CMS. So Duke hits it 38.5% of the time, and CMS hits it 34% of the time. So CMS is the one that we're going to go with. All right, so AEP isn't as good as CMS, and the XLU itself isn't as good as CMS. So this week, here's the plan. We are going to go long CMS at the open. I'm going to hold it all week long and close it at the end of the week. Now, here's the deal. I'm going to put a target in at 45.93. That is going to be my target. The reason why I'm going to put a target in there is because when it hits that level, it typically loses money. I'm also going to put a stop at 44.37. The reason I'm going to put a stop at 44.37, actually, you know what? I'm not going to put a stop there. It does have a tendency of closing when it hits that level. More often than not, it closes above it. It does slightly lose money, but I'm actually not going to put a stop there, but I am going to put a target at 45.93. So I'm going to have a target at 45. Whoop, I'm sorry. I was looking at the XLU. Okay, now let's look at the right one. So, okay, I am actually, yes, going to have a target. I'm actually not going to have a target at 35.89. It does lose money. All right, but more than 50% of the time that it hits the trend side, more than 50% of the time it closes above it. So I'm going to just let this kind of play out, but I am going to have a stop, all right? So if it hits 34.43, I am going to have a stop on CMS. So I'm going to go long at the open. My stop is going to be 34.43, and I'm going to hold it all week and close it at the end of the week. So basically, I won't have a target. If it doesn't hit 34.43, if I don't get stopped out, I'm holding it all week and closing it at the end. That is what I'm doing for my weekly trade CMS, and the reason why is because we're in an uptrend, and we've got a quality gauge above 50%. XLU is the best sector. That is the play. Let's talk about our monthly trade real quick. We are still long, and we're going to be long all week long until, well, technically all week long, but it'll be the end of the month is Thursday. Probably hold this through Friday. The XLV has a real good chance of being the best sector. XLV itself for the month is up about 2.83%. So this has been a really good trade. We've been long the XLV all month long. Best stock has been CAH. This has been a really good trade. XLV will probably be the best sector next month also, but I'll update you guys on that when we get an update. Let's talk about our daily trades. All right, so we now are back into an uptrend, bumping up and down, up and down, up and down, back into an uptrend. But the quality is below 50%. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take the XLV. All right, the XLV is the best sector, and I'm going to move all the stocks within the XLV on a daily basis. So I'm clicked on the daily tab. All right, I can see the XLV is the best sector. So I'm going to take all these stocks. I'm going to hit the plus symbol next to all these stocks. I'm going to take all these into my portfolio. Okay, and remember, CMS is our weekly stock, all right? And then I'm going to go and I'm going to use my pairing technique on this. So I'm going to look levels to win profit. I want to see a profit, all right? That we had a unique situation in the XLU, but all right, so I'm going to eliminate anything that doesn't make a profit on both sides, all right? So CI doesn't make a profit. And I might be going a little quick, but okay, so all these make a profit. So now how do we pare it down? You know, that's way too many. That's 8. How do we pare that down? Well, I'm going to use that same technique, and I'm going to find the one that has the widest spread between the trend side and the counter trend side levels on levels. Like this one has, a 27% spread. I like that. That's great. That is more than UHS. So I'm going to eliminate UHS. And it's more, well, it's about, well, no, it's actually more than STJ. It's more than the XLV. It's more than ABC. It's more than AET. Again, what I'm looking at is VAR, for example, closed at 95.50. It has a 30.8% probability of closing above this. Well, let's go through all this. It has a 51.9% chance of even hitting this. Its expected high today, 96.906, is a 51.9% probability. But it has, when it hits that, it has a 30.8% probability overall of closing above that. It makes money trading there. All right, so it only has a 3.8% chance of closing below 94.89. This is a good trade. This is a good one. Better than BDX. And, well, okay. And better than BCR. Okay, so our long is going to be VAR. VAR. I'm going to go long at the open. You can feel free to add that 96.09 because it's a profitable area. And then also if it sells off and hits 94.89, that's also another good area, okay? But on the daily dashboard, we are in an uptrend, but the quality is below 50%. Therefore, we need to go short. We need to pair that with a short position in the best shorting sector, which is the XLI. How do I know that? Well, the XLV is the best sector in the uptrend, best sector overall in the market. But as we go, it's ranked by, when it starts to turn purple, look at this, quality gauge is 57.9. It's ranked, all right, from essentially from left to right on which ones are the best. XLI is the best sector to go short. So now I'm going to take the XLI stocks and move them into my portfolio, and I'm going to find the best shorting opportunity. All right, so now I'm moving all these into my portfolio. We're going to find the one that we could pair this with, and I'm going to find the best shorting opportunity. And I'm using the same paradigm technique, looking for levels to win profits on both sides. So TXT I can eliminate. All right, I'm going through this fairly quickly. GE I can eliminate. Remember, CMS is from our weekly, so I don't even need to look at CMS. DHR I can eliminate. Okay, so now I'm going to use the same technique, and I'm going to look for the widest spread here. This spread is about 8% or so. And obviously that's not as good as AME. So AM, I'm going to eliminate XLI because AME is better. CMS we don't even need to look at, so 32 and 11, 32 and 9. So FLS is better than AME. So we've got 32 and 9, 26 and 9. Okay, so FLS is better than that one, better than 3M. Okay, so here we got one that's 25, and we've got 20, so PCP is actually better than FLS in multiple ways. PCP hits the trend side 57.7% of the time, compared to FLS only 51.9, and it hits the counter trend only 25% of the time, compared to FLS hits it 30.8% of the time. So PCP is the best stock to go short. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go long at the open, VAR. We can add at 96.09 if it hits that, or add at 94.89 if it hits that. Hold all day, close at the end of the day. Go short PCP at the open. You can add if it hits 198.62. You can add the position there because this thing has a tendency to sell off aggressively. Or if it hits 202.22, you can add to the position there. We had a couple trades that if you would have added to the position, a couple day trades, if you would have added the position last week, you would end up doing really well. But anyway, short PCP at the open, close at the end of the day. Same with the VAR. Go long, close at the end of the day. For our weekly trade, we are going to be long CMS. And CMS, we are going to have a stop, okay? We're going to go long CMS at the open. The only stop we're going to have is 34.43. If it doesn't hit that, we're going to hold it all week long, close at the end of the week. That is the play. For you subscribers or current trial subscribers that hasn't expired, I'm going to be posting right after this video. I'm going to post in the premium section under the resource, so you go to the resource tab. You watch these daily podcast videos under the podcast section, right? So that's free to everybody. Paying subscribers or non-paying subscribers, even subscribers that just log in and watch our podcast. But under the premium tab, this premium tab is only available to current trial subscribers within the 2 weeks or paying subscribers. I'm going to be posting my options trades, all right, the weekly options trades in that premium tab right after this video. I've got some amazing plays. There's about five of them. There's five of them. There's two credit spreads and then three straight calls. So great trades. I will be posting that right after this video. That is the plays for today and this week. Make it a great day, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.